Hey everybody, Radioactive here for another mod guide. Today is the second day of October, the second in hopefully a very long line of videos that I'm doing this month to celebrate the fourth birthday of my shop, Radioactive Designs, on Etsy. Link in the description. I will be showing you the installation video for the full kit version of the Dead Space Filler cap mod. So what we have here, so this is the full kit. This is going to be an orange internal hammer shot. Some of these things do change slightly depending on type of hammer shot internals you have. I will be doing the FPS tests with the elite darts that the blaster comes with, just to be fair. So the full kit comes with the regular cap spacer, a full compression spacer for the stock spring, a high performance O-ring, and a little foam gasket seal for the cap. Now let's get right into this. Oh, actually first, completely forgot to do this part. That's all right. We're gonna open this up and we're gonna put these five brand new elite darts, let me just throw this away, through the hammer shot. Now, so we got 65.7, 63.5, 59.8, 60.3, 65.5. I believe it gives me an average. No average. Now we're gonna open the blaster. This is probably the worst part of any mod, is opening the blaster. I don't know a single person who enjoys opening the blaster. But we are gonna go from start to finish. And what better place to start than opening the blaster? These screws are pretty tight. Oof. You really gotta try hard to break that initial rotation of the screw. So the mods that we're gonna do to this are only the kit. We're not gonna change the cylinder this time. We're not going to upgrade the spring, nothing else. So standard Hammershot performance, which you will have seen already by this point. All right, let's get this open. Make sure we do not lose any of our screws. That would not do well. Set this back over here. Put the cylinder off by itself. Put the parts that can fall out over there by themselves. Now we can put the shell back over here. We will not need that until we put everything back together. Take it all apart. Now, I did say there were some differences between this model and models that have tan, brown, black, white. I think there was like an olive drab type of color at some point as well. I think there was also a combination color. All those have a completely different, so the cap is solvent welded on these orange internal ones. And the plunger tube is actually slightly different. The O-ring doesn't work for some reason. I did try it in the 6SH, I tried it in the Hammerstorm, I tried it in an old-style Hammershot, and I tried it in this. And the orange internal Hammershot, it seems to be the only one the O-ring works in. So, let's open this, let's go ahead and get rid of our old O-ring. Just put that right there for future video or use, what have you. And install, it's a very simple install of the O-ring. Now you see, it's much looser. Now, this, that's how it's a, it basically acts like a speed seal, sort of. Much lower friction, much higher speed. The lobe size, the cross section, is much smaller than the other one. And then we're gonna set this aside. That's no longer needed. Gonna put your spacer aside. You'll only need that during installation. Make sure your pins, you don't lose your pins or your trigger spring or the trigger itself. Now, here's how I remove the plunger tube from the case, because you do need to remove it from the case. I press down right here on the plunger tube and up on this corner. And then just push it out. And it should do it again. And it comes out pretty easily. I did used to have some problems previously. Now, oof, this is a really, really slimy. It is brand new, so it is basically covered in silicone oil. Let me just get my trusty workshop toilet paper roll and try to clean some of that off, just to make it easier for us to modify it. You may need to come into with it for this seal. Jeez, it's still so slippery. God. Jeez, this is probably the most lubed up hammer shot I have gotten thus far. Ugh, gonna have to wash my hands after this. So, here we go. Alright, so what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take some tin snips. Actually, we're going to show the other way to do it. We're going to show the other way. So, let's see. Do I have a... Here it is. Do that. Take your... Not a hammer of choice. Did that break it? No, it did not. Damn. So you get the idea for that. I'm much better the other way of doing it. So what you can do is you can take a screwdriver, and you see the three arms that keep the bottom of it in check. Jeez, so much lube. You do see that down there. You can just break those off, and the AR falls right out, and you can do everything you need to do up here. So what I do, this is what I do here. Cut these two parts that just flew into my beard. You go into here and you cut at an angle that off, and then you cut as much as you possibly can off that side. So now it should be pretty open there. Get some pieces off to the side. You're going to now want to try and flip this thing sideways so you can get a hold of it. You can see how it's sideways in there now. I think it got away from me. Hold on. Okay. So now you're going to want to go in and cut as deep as you can. And now you got to try and flip it over so you can cut it in half. This is probably the most tedious part. Not that it's difficult, just it's tedious, and it requires some tools that you may not have. And this is just the way I go about it. Doesn't mean it's the best way or the only way. Now, try and pull your pieces of your broken up AR out. I can't seem to get a hold of it. I mean, you don't really have to be careful either. You're gonna tear up this cap no matter what you do. All right, so you got those parts out. Let me just toss these, throw them away. So much lube. And now, gotta take your tin snips and being careful to not hit the white plastic on the inside, you're gonna cut as deep as you can. Without hitting the plastic, and it did break. That's very good. It did break. All right, so now, because it did break, I can take my tin snips and just peel it. Now, that one didn't work quite as well as I'd hoped it would, but it did give us an opening to rip the entire cap off. Oh, this one was not solid welded well at all. Perhaps it wasn't solid welded. No, it was definitely solvent welded. Let's continue to do this here. And that was probably the easiest removal of the stock cap that I've ever had to deal with. So now you're going to take your tin snips and cut at the very bottom edge of this hinge. So that it is flush, there's nothing coming up, and you cannot cut too deep. Or you could have problems, a lot of problems, with seal problems. I said problems so many times there. And that will be a pain to fix in the future. So, less is more. You can always come back with an X-Acto knife. Or as Vile says, a sculpting tool. Now, there was a little bit here. Let's try and get rid of that. This is how I do it with my X-Acto knife. Now, you do not have to go through this whole problem if you have a regular, or not a regular, an old color internal case, because the cap, you can just pull the hinge this way, the hinge this way, the cap comes right off. You break up you cut off the hinges as you did here. It's a much easier removal. Ooh, excuse me. This needs to be cut off a little bit on my hammer shot right here. I got it pretty flush. I'm getting better at this every time I do it, and I surprisingly haven't done this that much. I think I've done it maybe a handful of times. I may cut some of this out because this is literally just me cutting off this excess plastic, the little bit of solvent weld. Be careful here not to cut yourself. I have sacrificed too much blood to the Nerf gods. Oh, I'm sorry. I forget. I'm mono-nerfistic. Not to get religious on y'all. The one true Nerf god is the Hammershot, of course. Alright, so that's probably good enough. Ah, that perfectionist in me. I'm good. That was not a cut. Oh, God. Be careful. Radioactive Designs is not liable for any damage you do to your blaster or yourself in the name of modification. Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to cut each of the three arms that are connecting the... That piece. Now, if you look closely, you can tell that there is a little bit sticking into the space here. You have to cut that out. You have to. It has to be 100% flush. Not 100% flush. There we go, that's pretty good. You also have to cut flush this piece and this piece. Always remember to be careful. Number one rule. Be safe. The less blood that you sacrifice to your blaster, the less of a pain it'll be later. I don't think there is a Hammershot that hasn't taken just a little bit of myself. That should be good. So now what I'm gonna have to do, because this is just so slick, we're gonna take our shop toilet paper or our paper towel or microfiber cloth, whatever you happen to have for this job. And we're gonna take some isopropyl alcohol. Remember, not for consumption. Just a little bit on the paper towel. This should help get rid of all of the grease on the outside. You especially want to get this lip, both inside and out, I'm also going to go ahead and do this. So that we can replace the lube with my preference and not quite so much. Just try and get off all of this lube from the blaster. That was ridiculous. All right, that should be good. So now what you're gonna wanna do, you have your cap, it's clean. The cap side goes this side, it's to my left. I don't know if you have two left hands. And the single nub is going to go to the top. You do not want it to be like this. It has to be this way. Now you are going to test fit. Be careful about your test fit. These things are really, really tight, not friction fit, and I'm having difficulty getting it on. So what we're going to do is we are going to cut some of this off and make a bevel. Not a lot. It really depends on your print settings as well. Like, I believe I have a seam right there, which always causes me problems. All right. Let's see if that fixed it. Sorry if you can hear my dogs downstairs. Oh, almost got it on. All right. So. That looks flat to me. Now here's the hard part, getting it back off. You may need to go in with this. Remember to be careful not to damage either part. And there we go. Okay, cool. All right, so for max contact area, I like to score this outer edge. It's not required at all for you to do so. This is just my preference. Helps give that silicone glue we're about to use something to hold on to. Now, you can use epoxy. I've seen hot glue. I've seen some gel-type super glues. All you have to do is make sure that this is 100% sealed to this. Now, we're going to take our glue here. Oh, well. So, we're just going to take that off. Oh yeah, that was completely sealed up. I'm probably gonna remove that damn bit of problems I had. So where is my dead cutoff of foam? Dead foam. Here we are. Should have been more prepared for this. Oh well. So here's a dead piece of foam. What I do like doing is to cut this foam in two, and then cut it in two again. And now we have four things that we have to, comfortable here. We now have four bits that we can use to spread our glue with. So, gonna put a couple of big globs. And then get the cap for our glue. I feel like I've gone backwards with the quality of these mod guides, even though this is only my second one. I'm gonna take this and kind of spread it. Pretty thick spread here. Make sure big globs don't go inside. It's fine if it does, but you don't want huge globs that go down inside the tube. We'll be able to clean this up later. Now, I'm gonna put some around the edge, around the top edge. Again, with the big globs. And toss this. It's no longer needed. Line it up correctly. And press. There we go. That's good. Clean off the glue that you got on your fingers. Make sure that there's no big globs of glue down inside. Maybe spread it around, try to get it into the gaps. Because no matter how perfect your design is, there's always going to be gaps. The way of the world. Alright. That's good. And then you're going to take this last piece of foam and spread the outside corner. Not corner, the outside, whatever this is. Alright. And you're all good. Now what we're going to do is we're going to let this sit here like this and harden and cure, and we're going to come back. Well, today is the first, so tomorrow we're going to come back. Now usually this takes a week to completely cure, but I'm pretty sure we're going to be fine for on a 24-hour schedule here. All right, everybody. It's been a few days. I believe it is the third today. I did let it sit a day more than I thought I would, just to be sure that this doesn't spring a leak or anything. I believe it is pretty good. Hold on. Yeah, blowing into it, I can't tell that there are any leaks or anything. So we are now going to glue the foam gasket on. I use this brush-on super glue, crazy glue. This is just how I do it. You could probably use something else. This is just preference. Make sure that front is all slathered. Be very careful to line this up. You only get one shot at it. Alright, that looks like it's pretty good. I don't know exactly where the camera lines up at. I usually press it flat against the my workspace. And it should be good now. So now we can put everything together. There we go. Make sure it's still able to move. I'm gonna put the lube back on these nubs right here. Just so we get nice, easy movement. Put this back over here. We are gonna use it in a moment. That should be good. You do need to be careful not to have big old globs of your lube on this ledge right here, because it does kind of interface with the this area. Right. Now I like to put it together like this back in the blaster itself, because in the orange internal compartment, for some reason these pins right here, they can just go completely through this. So it becomes really difficult when they just continue to fall through. I'm going to go ahead and put the smaller stainless steel one goes in here, and the longer black one goes where the hammer will be. I am going to take my lube and I'm going to put it inside this hole just a little bit. I'm going to wait. And then I'm going to put it inside this hole. Those are the holes that those pivots, these pins go through, that the blaster pivots on. It's just a much easier, makes it a little bit easier. I did forget to lube up the plunger tube, so let's just make sure that goes in there. So we did add a new O-ring, so it does need new lube. All right, here's this part. Here's this. This part is really irritating most of the time. You have to line it up just right. There we go. And now the hammer. So what I like to do when I do this, work it in. Then you could just put it on. I think that's almost everything. Where's my spacer at? There it is. Screw it all together. That is stripped, so I'll have to be careful of that in the future. That is also stripped. Ugh. Well, it's slightly stripped anyway. Alright, so here's how we put on the spacer. This is a max compression spacer. It pushes onto the bottom. Ah, it can be kind of difficult. Whew. All right, put in your small little pieces. If you want to keep them, that's totally up to you. And put back in your cylinder of choice. Now, I am going with the same old stock cylinder, so we get a really good FPS comparison. Put it all back together. Ah. Whatever. These things do have threads that they go back into. So if you can get them to line up right, they go in easily. Can't always. Oh, don't lose your screws. Luckily for me, I have tons of Nerf screws, tons of Hammershot screws, especially from all the Hammershots I have cut this front arm off of. It gives me two extra screws to use every single time, plus I do have a whole baggie of them that I've gotten. All right, that should be almost completed. And I didn't do this one. This is the last one. Make sure it is. Oh, it wasn't. I lost a screw. Uh-oh. I didn't hear it hit the ground. That's unfortunate. Oh well, I'll go look for that. I'll get it screwed back in, and I'll come back to you with FPS numbers with... Ooh, that was tight. With the new, Uh-oh, we're not rotating. Why are we not rotating? We're having rotation problems. Interesting. I don't know why. Alright, so we're gonna reopen this. I'll get back to you when I do that. Alright, so now that we have this blaster open, we can try and find where there may be problems. Can't tell if this is lube on it or if it's just that glossy. We can try to put lube on this back face. That should not affect this, negatively affect the seal at all. Let's just get some on here. We can also put lube on this front area right here, underneath the front post. Because the blaster does, the cylinder does ride on the front of the blaster on that post. We can also try to lube up the peg, the rotation peg, and this part, but it looks like it has plenty of lube on it already. Put this back in. You can see how tight that is. This is how I test the seal. That was okay. Wasn't terrible. I'm not really sure. Is this Is this moving easily enough? Doesn't really feel like it. It could move better. All right, so what we're now going to do, I'm going to take this off and I'm going to try and, I mean, I told you this was maybe an issue before. I told you this could be an issue. See, this is why we do this. Go through all the little things. And eventually we will get to a performing blaster. Let's take everything back apart. I did find that screw that I dropped, so that's good. And now it's all lubey. I hate this. Woo. Yeah. So you can see, sort of. Hold on. Ooh, that almost fell. So, let's go down that way, so it'll be this side, which is the problem. I'm just gonna have to re-lube this. So, because I use silicone lube and silicone glue, it actually will hurt the glue a little bit. At least the outside part. The inside part, it will not affect very much. I don't know how well you can see this, but it's already pulling off the glue. The combination of like the friction, everything else, it is pulling that off. So let's try and scrape some of it off to get a better seal. Do I have? Where's my phone? Here it is. Can do it this way. Because then it'll just pull all that stuff off. And once there is, yeah, so you can just scrape it off at this point. This won't affect your seal, probably. If you've done it right, it won't. I just do it just to be safe. Kind of pushes some of that glue down in there. It's really unfortunate. Oh well. These things happen. If I had a perfect mod guide every single time, you wouldn't know how to get through the little optimizations that are needed. And now, blow off any of this excess. Knock all this onto your floor. Very important. All right, now let's put this back in. There should be plenty of lube on the inside of this, so you shouldn't need to re-lube this. All right. Uh-oh. Come on. Loose. Now that it's back together, yeah, it feels like it's much easier. All right. Put everything back together just like we did previously. Oh, that does happen occasionally. put this back together. All right, cool.
Line it all up.
Make sure you didn't drop any of your little pieces out. Oh yeah, that feels easier. That could just be because the cylinder. Okay, you see how that moves? That's much nicer. Put our spacer back in. This gets harder and harder the more greased up your hands are. Oof. We get it in the end. All right. Now, this blaster will end up being the basis for the rest of the mods that I do, at least for the Hammershot. Well, some of the basic mods. Some of the more extensive mods that I do over this next month, they could include intermediate kit upgrade Hammershot. I think I've already gone over that, so that should be perfectly fine to just continue on with. Now, make sure that I got all these screws in. So the next one I do will probably be a 16-shot cylinder put into this blaster. I got everything. Yep. And now let's see how it rotates. It does rotate better. It does have some problems still though. Interesting. Those will work themselves in. Sometimes that's needed. The seal, the way the tolerances are, the seal could be pressed into it a little bit too much. If you continue to have these rotation problems, you're going to need to actually glue in this piece. Now, it makes it slightly harder to install cylinders, but it can be required. I have to do it for my my really, really highly upgraded ones, or else the rotation becomes an issue. Alright, so now I'm gonna go ahead and get. Yeah, see, it's not rotating as well anymore. Alright, so I'm gonna go and get those performance numbers. I'll be right. Alright, now that FPS testing is completed, let's see what kind of performance we got. Go to shot memory, start at the lowest it lets us. All right, number one, I don't know how well you can see this. 88.9, 87.6, 89.9, this hit the side of the chrono. 85.9, 90.3, 94.9, 97.6, 81.3, 90.4, and ending off on 80.1. So about 90 feet per second. just on that one, this one basic hit. Now, this will go up if you get a better cylinder. If you get one of the brass cylinders that I have. I wonder if I have the brass to make that for this month. It'll go up if you use the intermediate kit. It'll go up if you use the basic 8-round... ammo improvement. Higher number. If you have a better cylinder, it will go higher. You could be hitting low hundreds with this thing. And this is just with the stock spring and a spacer. If you put in an 8-kilogram spacer, then you'll definitely be hitting 100, 110, 100% with a better cylinder. Now, I didn't have a single rotation problem, so this could just be one of those cases of it needs that oomph from the blaster hitting. And I know y'all are cringing from that dry fire, but this does have a silicone spacer stock, a silicone thing on the bottom of the hammer, so it's taking even more force than what this one, the front of the plunger tube would. This is why I hate it when people say, oh, if you take out the AR, it'll break your blast. No, it won't. I put 26 kilograms in one of these, and the only part that broke was a 3D printed part. That was it. I saw no other stress marks or anything. So, yeah. So, 90 FPS from about 60 FPS. That is an increase of, what, 50%? 66, I guess it depends on how you look at it. I'm going to say 50%. 50% on the full basic kit upgrade. It's wild. It's pretty crazy. Now, I've showed you exactly how to do this. I don't want to hear any more, oh, well, if you can't mod a hammer shot unless your name is Radioactive. No excuses. No excuses. All right. Yeah, so this was the basic upgrade kit. I'm probably going to change the name at some point, but everybody knows it as the Dead Space cap filler mod. So that's, I guess, whatever. Get it while the getting's good. There is still a sale going on for 20%. It's been Radioactive. Have a good day.